What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In our previous uploads, we mentioned several times the priority or the precedence of an operator. However, we never tackled this topic separately in its own video. That's what we are going to do today. Now, before we dive in the topic at hand, let's briefly go over the different types of operators available in Java, their syntax, and how to use them. Java operators are divided into six different categories: arithmetic, assignment, relational, logical, unary, and bitwise operators. Arithmetic operators are used to perform mathematical tasks on variables and data. To your left-hand side, what you can see are the various arithmetic operators provided by Java, and to your right-hand side are a few examples of these operators and the output they will yield if used. Java's assignment operators, as you may have guessed, are used to assign values to variables. In the first example, we are assigning the value 10 to the variable integer, and in the second example, we are assigning the sum of integer and 20 to the same integer variable. Now, concerning Java's relational operators, we use them to check the relationship between two operands. As you can see, the result of such operators is a Boolean, either true or false. Next are logical operators. I assume these are among the ones you use the most. They are used to check whether an expression is true or false, or in other terms, in decision-making. The example we have will yield false when used with the AND logical operator, as one side of the operand is true and the other is false. However, the same one will result in true when used with the OR operator. Okay, unary operators are used with one operand only, and the operation applied on this operand is either to increment it, decrement it, or invert it. The increment and decrement operators can be used as prefixes or as postfixes. If you use the ++ operator, for example, as a prefix, the value of the variable is incremented by 1, then the value is returned. But if you use the ++ operator as a postfix, the original value of the variable is returned first, then the variable is incremented by 1. We will get into more details in a few minutes. Finally, the bitwise operators are used to perform operations on individual bits. These are generally not used in Java, and in all of my years as a Java developer, I've never made use of any. However, I'll leave a list of these operators and examples of their usages on the screen for you, so feel free to pause the video and take a look at them. Now that you have an idea about all the operators provided by Java, let's tackle the main topic, the precedence of these operators. And simply put, the precedence of an operator determines the order in which the operators of a given expression are evaluated. To understand what I mean, take a look at the following statement. Mathematically, we know that the multiplication has a higher priority than the addition, hence the following equation will be equivalent to this one and not that one. This means that the multiplication sign has a higher precedence than the add sign, and consequently, while calculating a given statement, the evaluation of the multiplication will precede that of the addition. But what if we had something like this? Not just mathematical, but logical. In this case, and following the table of precedence you see in front of you, the AND logical operator will be evaluated before the OR because it has a higher precedence. As you might have also noticed, expressions inside parentheses are always evaluated first, as they have the highest priority. So, if you are dealing with multiple operators and operands in a single expression, you can use parentheses for clarity and simplicity. Now, this precedence table can and will be the answer to almost all of your problems related to this topic. However, what if we had something like this? You see, in this example, we are only using AND operators. So, should we evaluate the left or the right one before the other? If we were making use of the plus and minus signs, we would know that the addition in this case, or the one to the left, is to be evaluated first, even though they both share the same precedence. Why? Well, because of something called associativity. If two or more operators with similar precedence exist within the same expression, then this expression is evaluated according to its associativity, either left to right or right to left. In the associativity column we added to our table, you can see that the AND operator has an associativity of left to right, which means that in our previous example, the left AND operator is executed first. By the way, do not worry about memorizing everything here. Most of the time, the precedence and associativity of operators make sense in itself, just like it does in mathematics. And you can always come back here for reference when in doubt. Okay, before ending the video, I've decided to put together the 8 expressions you see. Now, what I hope you'll do is put everything you've learned these past few minutes to the test and try to come up with the result of these expressions. So, if you want to go through this exercise, pause the video now. If not, the answers will appear in 5. And here you go. These are the results. Let me know in the comments if you got all of them right. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.